Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create a custom toolbar for the .NET MAUI PDF Viewer control. You'll see how to open a PDF file from the local machine, navigate a document, show the overall page count, and zoom in and out using a custom toolbar. First, I open an existing .NET MAUI application, where I have added the Syncfusion .NET MAUI PDF Viewer. By installing the Syncfusion.NET MAUI PDF Viewer package using the NuGet package manager. I have set the binding context to bind data between the view and view model. If you would like to know how to do this, check out the video link in the card above. I run the application on the Android platform. Here you can see the PDF Viewer rendered with the loaded file. Next, I will show you how to add a custom toolbar. I use the grid layout to place our custom toolbar above the PDF viewer. Now, I remove the code already declared here. And use a grid control to define a layout grid with 3 rows. I will place the toolbar item at the top of the PDF viewer control. So, I define a child grid with 3 columns inside a parent grid. Next, I will show you how to implement the open file function. To do that, I'm going to use the button. The button style defined in the resources section can be used to apply a consistent visual appearance to multiple button controls in the application. Now, I add the button control inside the grid layout and name it open file. I set the text property of the button to the icon character, which is the Unicode character specified in the font file. Also, the button will be positioned at the zeroth column of the grid. Based on the platform, I retrieve a PDF file from local storage using this button. I open the PDF Viewer View Model class. And here, I'm going to create the iCommand property which is used to open a file by clicking the Open File button. So let me create a field for the iCommand property. And define the open file command property here. Then, I create a new instance for the open file command property and pass the open file method as an argument to the command. Now, I will define the open file method which was assigned to the open file command property. This method will be executed when the command is executed. Within this method, I use the FilePicker FileType class and DeviceType to select compatible files in a FilePicker based on the device. In this method, a FilePicker FileType object is created with a dictionary that maps the different platforms to a list of file types. For example, on iOS, the FileType public.pdf is allowed, which corresponds to PDF files. Like the iOS platform, I have set the appropriate file extension types for the other platforms like Android, Windows, and Mac Catalyst. Here, I use the FilePicker FileType object to create a FilePicker that allows me to choose only PDF files. I customize the FilePicker using the PickOption object, setting the picker title as, please select a PDF file. And the file types to the previously created PDF file type object. Then, I pass these picker options as a parameter to the pick and show method calling in the open file method. Within the pick and show method, I will call the pick async method to select a PDF file. If the result object is not null, then, I use the OpenReadAsync method to open the selected file and assign its stream to the PDF document stream property. Next, I bind the OpenFile command to the button command property. I run the application on the Android platform. You can see the custom toolbar at the top of the .NET MAUI PDF viewer control. I'm going to load a new document using the Open button in the toolbar. Next, let's see how to implement the page navigation function. I add an entry control in our grid layout to get the page number and name it page number entry. I open the PDF Viewer View Model class. Here, I define the page number field. Then I define the page number property. By using this property, you can get the value of page number and also set the new value to the page number property. Then I define the onPropertyChanged method, and it's used to raise an event or perform additional actions when a page number value changes. Next, I open the main page. I bind the page number property of the data context to the text property. I use the completed event to detect when I entered a new page number. When I finish entering the text and trigger the completion event, the page number entry completed method is executed, which in turn navigates to a specific page in a PDF viewer control. I also added attributes and events to define the appearance and behavior of the entry control, such as its size, input restrictions, alignment, and event handling. I use a label to show the overall number of pages in the document. I set the horizontal text alignment, vertical options, and vertical text alignment to the center to align the label to the center. At the same time, I define the page count property in PDF Viewer View Model class. I declare a private integer field underscore page count to store the value of the page count property. Then define a property named page count of type int with a getter and a setter. GetAccessor retrieves the value of the page count variable and returns it. SetAccessor is used to assign a new value to the page count variable. The onPropertyChanged method is typically used to raise an event or perform any other action when the page count property is changed. Next, I bind the text property of the label control to the page count property of the data context. Whenever the value of the page count property changes, the label will automatically update its text content to reflect the new value. You can see the total number of pages displayed in the label control here. If you want to go to page 5, you enter the page number in the entry box and click the Enter button. Now, it's navigated to that page. Next, I'm going to show you how to implement the next and previous page navigation functions using button command binding. I add two buttons to our PDF viewer interface. And name the first button as the previous page and the second as the next page. I set the text property of both buttons to the icon character, which is the Unicode character specified in the font file. Then I set the font size of the button's text content to 16 units. I bind the command property of each button to corresponding iCommand objects. The command property of the button control is bound to the goToPreviousPage command and goToNextPage command properties within the PDF viewer object. When the button is clicked, it will execute the command defined in the goToPreviousPage command property, which is typically associated with the action of going to the previous page in the PDF viewer. I also disable the next and previous buttons when the user is already on the first or last page of the PDF. We can do this by validating the page number and page count properties in the validate page number method, and setting the true or false for the can go to previous page and can go to next page properties that bind the isEnabled property of the buttons. Using this isEnabled property, we can enable and disable the button in the property changed event. Now going to bind the can go to previous page and can go to next page properties to the isEnabled property of the button control. If these properties are true, the button will be enabled, else the button will be disabled. I can navigate to the next and previous pages of the document now. Finally, I'm going to show you how to implement the zoom in and zoom out operations. I add two buttons to our main page. Name the first button the zoom out, and the second button the zoom in. I set the text property of both buttons to the icon character, which is the Unicode character specified in the font file. In our PDF Viewer View Model class, I define the iCommand objects for the zoom in and zoom out operations. I use the Command class for this purpose. I declare two private fields, zoom in command and zoom out command of type iCommand. These fields are most likely intended to be used to store instances of iCommand implementations for the zoom in and zoom out actions, respectively. I define these zoom in command and zoom out command as public properties. These properties return the value of the zoom out command and zoom in command fields. I define the event handler function for the zoom in and zoom out operation in the constructor of the class. The event handler functions for the zoom in and zoom out operations use the zoom in and zoom out methods of the PDF viewer to increase or decrease the current zoom, respectively. I also enable or disable the zoom in and zoom out buttons based on the current zoom level of the PDF viewer using the zoom factor property in the validate zoom change method. I bind the zoom in and zoom out commands in the corresponding button commands and set the isEnabled property. Next, I bind this current zoom property to the PDF viewer zoom factor property in the main page. Finally, I ran the application and see the output in the Android platform. Now, I can zoom in and out of the document using the button. Navigate to the next and previous pages of the document. You can switch the platform to Windows, iOS, or macOS, and the control will display and behave similarly. Now, let's check the output in the Windows platform. Here, you can observe the similar functionality of the PDF viewer, just like Android. It enables you to effortlessly load a new document, navigate to a specific page, and easily zoom in or out of the pages. In this video, I have shown you how to create a custom toolbar in the Syncfusion.NET MAUI PDF Viewer component for opening a PDF file from the local machine, navigation, showing the overall page count, and zooming. If you want to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I will also include a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and we hope to catch you in the next video.